In this video, we're looking at a propagation of error calculation with the spring potential energy formula. Now, I actually gave this problem to my class before they'd even heard of spring potential energy. You don't really need to know what it is in order to do the error calculation, but you do have to pay careful attention to the units that we're looking at in the problem. So we're told that potential energy for a spring is 1/2 kx², where k is the spring constant, x is the displacement of the spring from its natural length, and we're told that the units come out to joules if we measure the spring constant in newtons per meter and if we measure the displacement in meters. And that's a key point for this problem because we're actually given the displacement x in centimeters, and that has to be converted immediately. So I'm going to write x in meters. I just shift the decimal point twice and I get 0.175 plus or minus 0.002 meters for that. I may as well copy k right here just so we have it as an easier reference. It's 10.1 plus or minus 0.7 newtons per meter. So we're guaranteed that our potential energy is going to come out in joules. And we're asked to compute the spring potential energy and then put a plus or minus on it by using propagation of error. So the first step in this process is to just get the potential energy itself. That's 1/2 kx², and we just plug in the k and the x. And the k was 10.1. The x is 0.175, and I need to square that. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.1547, just keeping some extra precision for now, and that's joules. Now, the real meat of the calculation here is finding the uncertainty in that, and we have to use the propagation of errors formula that includes a product of two measured variables where one or more of them could be raised to an exponent because we have an exponent of 2 on that displacement. So quoting the propagation of errors formula, I have the relative uncertainty in potential energy, that's the uncertainty divided by the potential energy itself, is equal to the square root of the uncertainty in the spring constant over the spring constant squared. And that's because that was raised only to the first power. And then I have a 2 out in front of my delta x over x. Before I square it, the 2 is there because the exponent on that in the potential energy formula was 2. Now we just plug the numbers in. And when we run the numbers on this, we get about 0.0730. Now that number actually has an interpretation. That's basically a percent error. It's a 7.3% error is what that's telling us because that's the uncertainty in the potential energy divided by the potential energy itself. But what we want in this problem is the delta PE, the actual uncertainty. That requires us to multiply both sides by the potential energy to isolate that delta PE. And our potential energy was 0.1547 joules. Our relative uncertainty, in other words, the right-hand side of that previous equation, was 0.0730. And I get an uncertainty of 0.011 joules. Now, ordinarily, it's a convention in my classes to round the delta to one significant digit. So I'm going to write this as 0.01 joules. The next thing we do is round the actual quantity that we were computing, the potential energy, to the same decimal place that's being addressed by the uncertainty. So there's uncertainty in the hundredths place, and that means we shouldn't bother to express any digits beyond the hundredths place. So in this case, we're going to round down to a 0.15 for my potential energy, and then plus or minus 0.01. And don't forget to put the units on that, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.